Have you ever heard of index match in Excel? That's when we use the index and match functions together to look up a value in a data set and then return the matching value from the corresponding column or row. You might wonder, well, isn't that what VLOOKUP is for? Why should I learn two functions when one function does the job just fine? Well, let's look at just fine for a moment. Here, we can use VLOOKUP to extract data from this data set, as long as the unknown values are to the right of the known value. So here, if we know the product number and we want to use that to look up information about that product, everything that we want to extract must be to the right of the product number. Most times we are able to comply with this requirement by rearranging the source data if we have to. But if that source data serves another purpose which prevents us from changing the format, it becomes a problem. Second, for lookups where approximate matches are accepted, the source data must be sorted in ascending order. Lists which are sorted in descending order will return incorrect results. Again, you may not have this much control over the data in your lookup array. So this is why we may find ourselves going back to nesting the two functions that got the whole lookup process started in the first place, index and match. If you're serious about using Excel, then you should get comfortable with the index and match combo. So now let's break down each function individually. First, let's delete the VLOOKUP formula that we used to extract information at our paper company. And now let's learn about the match function. This function tells you the position number of a value within a range of cells. So in this list, for instance, the value carbon is the second item in the range. It's in position number 2. Here's what match needs to know to return a position number. Let's start with the function name and open parenthesis. The lookup value will be, let's start with the word carbon. Since this is a text value, we'll just type it within double quotes and then our comma. Next, we need the lookup array. That's where to look. That's going to be the range here, B2 to B9. Those are the two basic required arguments. There's an optional argument, match type, where you can tell Excel what to do if the lookup value wasn't found in the array. If you type a 1, Excel accepts a near match rounded down to the next available value. That's the default if you omit this argument when entering the formula. If you type a 0, that means you'll only accept an exact match. If Excel doesn't find it, then you'll get an NA error message. If you type a -1, then Excel accepts a near match rounded up to the next available value. For text values, exact match is the only one that's really practical. So let's type a 0, and we close parentheses, and match does return a value of 2, because carbon is the second item within our array. So that's the basic functionality of match. Now let's talk about the index function. Index returns an actual value that matches the lookup value. If you can imagine a restaurant menu where prices are listed both in US dollars and Canadian dollars, and if you want to know the price in Canadian dollars, which is the third column, then when you've located the burger you want to buy, then you might run your finger across to the appropriate column to get the price in your currency of choice. Then you'd stop when you get to that figure and mentally register the price. It's 8 Canadian dollars for a beef burger. The menu here is acting like an index. So now let's see how the index function works in Excel. Just like the match function, index also has 2 required arguments and 1 optional. We'll use the array format because we want Excel to return the actual value and not just the cell reference. First, we'll enter our array, which is the entire source data set. We type a comma to get to the next argument. Now we need the row number where the return value will be located. This argument can be omitted if the array consists of only one row. But if row number is omitted, then the column number, which is the third argument, is required. So here we want the price of a beef burger, which is going to be row 3. And column number is where the cell containing the return value can be found. Again, this argument is optional, but it is required if row number is omitted. We know that what we want will be coming from the third column, which has values in Canadian dollars. So that's column 3. We close parentheses, and we have our answer. So now we know how both functions work individually. Let's combine them for some real action. Combining formulas in Excel is also known as nesting. Nesting a formula means using one entire formula as an argument of another function. Let's revisit our paper company to extract the values using the product number as an input or lookup value. First, we'll use match to determine where in the list the product number falls, the position number. So let's type our function name, match, and open parenthesis. And our lookup value will be our known value, what's typed in G2. And we know that product numbers will always appear here, so that's the lookup array. We want an exact match to the product number, so we type 0 for the match type. Close parentheses and enter. Product 2209 is the 8th item in our lookup array. So we found the position number of product 2209. Now let's get in front of the match function with index. We'll type index and open parentheses. Excel shows us the format of the index function. We know that our array will be this entire data set, comma, and match has already found the row number, so that was the second argument. We type a comma to get the column number. Well, what we want here is the paper type, so the column number will be 2. Close parentheses and hit enter. Product number 2209 is Losheen. So we can see that our lookup was performed correctly using the index and match combination. And now we can do the same for price and number of items in stock, either by repeating this process manually or copying this formula downward. We can copy the formula downward once we lock these values in. On our Windows keyboard, we hit F4 after each reference. If you're using a Mac keyboard, then you do Command T. Let's copy these down. And now all we have to do is change the column number here. Price is column 3, and items in stock, column 4. This needs to be in dollars. So everything here looks great. Remember we mentioned that index match solves the left lookup and descending order problems that VLOOKUP can't handle? Let's look at an example here. Here there are two columns of data missing, student name and letter grade. The problem is that student names are to the left of the student ID, which means that VLOOKUP is kind of stuck because it can't do that. And the letter grades are over here in this data set, but the grades are sorted in descending order, so that's a problem for VLOOKUP too. Let's solve this the way we just learned. In my opinion, it's easier to start with match, then get in front of it with the index, so we'll do that now. Our lookup value will be the student ID. The lookup array will be here. And we can start by locking this right now, F4 or Command T. And of course, we want an exact match, so we type 0. Close parentheses. That's our match function. Let's do a quick check, see if this is right. It says student ID 114, 125 is in position 5. And that's right. So now we just need to link this with the index function to return the student's name. So let's type index, open parenthesis, and the array will be this entire array. We can hit F4 to make this a fixed range, type a comma, and we have our second argument because match already returned the row number. And so now we need our third argument, which is the column number. That's going to be column 1 for the student name. We close parentheses and hit enter. And this student ID is associated with Emily Edwards. So now we just copy this to the remaining rows. We can double click, and that works great. Now here we have the letter grade. Since the letter grade chart only lists 5 values, student scores may not be an exact match because, of course, students can score anywhere between 0 and 100%, but there are only 5 values here. So the match type within the match formula has to be adjusted to accept an approximate match. So let's start with the match function. The lookup value will be the test score, and the test scores will be found here. This is a fixed array, so we hit F4 or Command T. And now the match type will be an approximate match. Will we use less than or greater than? Well, we can see here that we want a greater than. So if, for instance, a student gets 85%, then we know we'll want to see the letter A because it matches to the next larger value. So we do -1 and close parenthesis. Let's get in front with the index function. And our array will be this entire array. Locked as an absolute reference, we have our second argument, and now we need the third argument, which will be column 2. We double click, and index match does the work for us, which VLOOKUP could not do because this is sorted in descending order. So, although VLOOKUP was made to simplify the common task of finding items in a table, and it does work great most of the time, we can't discard index match for certain situations. Here's something you might want to know. Excel has rolled out XLOOKUP as the fix for the above complaints about VLOOKUP's limitations. The drawback is that for now, it's only available on Excel 365. So if you have an older version, you'll definitely want to understand and master index match.
Ready to learn more about Microsoft Excel? Then check out the full course on GoSkills.com. Click the link in the description.